Amigos míos, estoy en un evento de Brand USA. Para mí es todo, está muy nuevo porque pues acabo de tener visa y estoy así como, ¿qué voy a hacer? ¿Qué destinos voy a ver? Y una de mis paradas, y la razón incluso de que me dieran la visa, fue porque dije que iba a ir a South by Southwest. Es uno de los festivales más icónicos de tecnología, de música, donde se junta bastante gente creativa. Y uno de los lemas de Austin es Keep Austin Weird. Y por eso, bueno, no exactamente por esa razón, pero Clarisa de León nos va a platicar un poco de este destino para todos los amantes de la tecnología y de la música. Clarisa, thank you so much for joining us here.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Well, tell me more about the South by Southwest Festival. I've heard a lot. I have a friend there, and he says that the whole week the people doesn't work because they are so dedicated to the festival. So please let me know what happened there.
Sure, yeah. So South by Southwest is a huge festival that's attended nationally and internationally. It spans over 2 weekends. It's about 10 plus days, and it covers technology, fashion, obviously music. Yes. Music is such a big pillar. Video gaming, there's movie premieres. Yes. Anything that you can think of, it's there. And wow. So you know, in Austin too, we're definitely a tech startup city as well, so you're gonna see a lot of cool up-and-coming tech companies presenting ideas. You're gonna see up-and-coming musicians locally and nationally, so it's a really great stage to be on, to it's a great platform to have to talk about your ideas and whatever product it is that you have.
What would be the event that is closest in terms of the concept of South by Southwest? I mean, we just saw what happened on CES in Las Vegas, and this is very electronic and it's the future. But how could you possibly compare to another event that we could see in other part of the world?
I don't know. I guess South by Southwest is kind of uniquely its own thing. But to kind of give you some past examples, so if you're familiar with Jordan Peele, so Us, that movie premiered at South by Southwest. And some kind of like top tech companies premiered and they had events there. You have artists. So last year there was Khaled, who's an American artist. J Balvin was also there. So you know, there's a big variety of people. It's very diverse. So you can kind of expect to see probably, for as far as movies are concerned, the top movies for 2020, you'll likely see at least one or two of them premiering at South by Southwest. As far as tech is concerned, there's going to be a lot of new kind of creative developments.
And Jack Dorsey is going to be in this year.
Yeah, he's CEO of Twitter. Yes, he's going to be there. Stephen Colbert is going to be there too.
Oh,
so
yeah. Okay,
we're guaranteed to have some laughs. It's going to be really fun. ASAP Rocky, he's also been a past participant.
I'm so excited that Brené Brown, the Dr. Brené Brown, who's she speaks a lot of the human nature in the new in the new century. He's been studying a lot and how the millennial and centennial thing is evolving. But I think she's a great author in terms of humanity and probably sociology too. I'm excited.
Yes, yeah, and that's a great thing too. I mean, you're gonna find tons of awesome speakers, and like, where else can you get like some of like the world's top speakers, top scientists, top performers all in one city?
So it doesn't happen in a place, like, you know, a hotel. The whole city is dedicated to a festival?
Mainly it's going to be at the Austin Convention Center.
Oh, okay. Uh-huh.
But there are a lot of companies that will rent out venues, and so there are going to be a lot of offsites. And then as far as the music is concerned, there's so many music venues within the city where there's going to be shows. There's going to be a lot of free shows. Majority of it is going to take place at the convention center, but there's going to be a lot of areas within the downtown city center where there will also be events as well.
So I heard that probably it was a good scoop to be seen for new entrepreneurs, for startups. What would you say to the Mexican startups who want to expand their limits and go there? What would you say to them?
Yeah. Well, I would encourage Mexican entrepreneurs, definitely try to attend and use South by Southwest as a platform. South by Southwest actually just opened brand new offices within the heart of downtown as well. So even if you don't have the opportunity to come in March, definitely reach out to them, you know, and kind of start a relationship. Also, we have so many other up-and-coming tech companies. Reach out to them too and see if there's any opportunity to maybe co-op or work together for maybe future South by Southwest opportunities or even just other opportunities throughout the year.
So it's at the end of March, right?
It is, it's the 13th through the 22nd. So right in the middle of March, right around spring break.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah, yeah. So even better because, you know, people are off of work or off of school. And so they have the opportunity to attend.
So what else is in Austin? What would you say to the people that can possibly plan a trip to go 3 or 4 days apart from South by Southwest?
Sure, yeah. So Austin, we are the live music capital of the world.
Yes,
so,
and Austin City Limits.
Yes, also, Austin City Limits, yes. Yeah, so it is a must. You must
in
listen
Mexico,
to live music.
The Austin City Limits program, TV program, is an HBO. But always I heard the same TV program.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
It's just a classic.
Yes. And actually, Austin City Limits is the longest continuous show. So ACL Live.
Yes.
It's the longest continued recorded show. So it's over like 20 years, I think. And the first show, and so he's kind of like our patron saint of Austin, but it was Willie Nelson. So
but
he's kind
amazing.
Of like our patron saint of Austin.
Yes.
And so, yeah, so definitely, you know, listen to live music. We have over 250 live music venues. So there's always opportunity to listen to live music 7 days a week, all different kinds of music. And definitely try the food. Barbecue is super, super popular in Austin.
I always think about House of Cards when I see the image of the barbecue, but yes.
Yeah. And so it's absolutely delicious. If I could eat it every day, I would. And so definitely if you kind of want to do more of a traditional and a really iconic Austin barbecue, I would definitely recommend going to Franklin Barbecue. Mm-hmm. So in 2015, Aaron Franklin was the first ever barbecue chef, or actually should say pitmaster mm-hmm. to win a James Beard Award. Never before had that ever been done. Barbecue is, you know, not necessarily seen as other kind of like different types of culinary cuisines. And so for a pitmaster to be awarded a James Beard Award is a huge thing. So definitely, you know, experience Franklin Barbecue, but also be prepared to wait. The line can, you know, take a couple of hours, but you can bring foldable chairs and beer. So you'll enjoy yourself while you
January.
Wait.
Yeah,
you're
yeah.
On
diet. But okay.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's
but
no diet in Austin, you know.
So by that time, I will be very, very different.
And calories don't count when you're on vacation.
Ah, okay,
so.
Okay. I'm going to put it in a tattoo, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
And what is the weird part about Austin?
Sure, so Keep Austin Weird really kind of originated as a way to, weird as in a sense of keeping it local and supporting local businesses, small businesses. So when we say Keep Austin Weird, we really mean keep it local. So support local businesses. And you'll see tons of local businesses in Austin, whether it's restaurants, spas, clothing stores, you know, little souvenir shops. So we're really, really big on keeping things local, supporting local small business.
Yeah.
Yes, definitely, definitely.
That is amazing.
So that's why we say Keep Austin Weird, because we want to continue to support small businesses and really help them thrive and continue to succeed in Austin.
That's amazing. Okay. Well, so you have an opportunity to go, to visit, to expand your horizons, and to listen to your next favorite band. Believe me, the sounds are very different, and you will find something that you like. So thank you so much for your time.
And actually, mm-hmm. if I could, if you're looking for more information about Austin, go to www.visitaustin.org. We have itineraries, we have things to do,
and social media,
food and drink,
right?
Yeah, and our social media too.
That's very good. Please visit, because if we are on Instagram, we just, you know, landscapes and everything, the whole experience. So in Mexico, we have the inventados, that is people who are like very show off.
Oh, okay,
and
okay.
They post it on Instagram.
Okay.
So if you are an inventado, you have to go there and take your selfie there and discover new horizons. Thank you so much, Clarissa,
yes,
for
thank
your time.
You.
And thank you so much for this, and please share it, and please comment if you want to see more interviews like this, and if you want to translation, if you want your subtitles, please let me know, and thanks so much. Okay.
Awesome. Thank you.